things shake, things fall down. But we believe in the Lord who is not moved, who is not shaken by the things of this world. For we serve that mighty God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So, मैं सोच रहा था कि मैं क्या शेयर करूं. Obviously, दिमाग में इतनी सारी चीजें चलती हैं, सिचुएशन को लेके कुछ बोलना है. So, I want to share something very basic. I hope I'll be able to finish it quickly in time. And I hope this will bless you. Before this, there are two things that are going to happen today. Okay? One, I'm going to share the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Second thing, we are going to apply it in our lives. Can you say that with me? We are going to apply it in our lives. The word of the Lord tells us, do not be the hearers of the word, but be the doers of the word. Right? That's what the Lord expects from us. मैंने अपने मैसेज को कोई टाइटल तो नहीं दिया है, बट मैं बहुत ही बेसिक और इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज शेयर करना चाहता हूँ आप सबके साथ. इस पेंडेमिक में हमारे मन में आता ना कि क्या करना चाहिए, फिजूल वक्त है, शायद ज्यादा फ्री टाइम मिल गया. कुछ लोग शायद उसे ज्यादा काम कर रहे हैं वर्क फ्रॉम होम के टाइम पे. सम आर वर्किंग फ्रॉम होम, सम आर वर्किंग एट होम, आई डोंट नो, राइट? बट दिस इज द टाइम, यू नो. आप अगर कुछ मछुआरों को जानते हो, मैं केरला में रहता हूँ, अभी मैं त्रिवेंद्रम प्रदेश में हूँ. 2012 में मैं केरला आया यहाँ पे अपनी पढ़ाई के लिए, मास्टर्स के लिए. मेरी मर्जी नहीं थी, मैंने कभी नहीं सोचा कि मैं इतने साल रहूँगा, बट 8 साल हो गए मुझे यहाँ पे. तो यहाँ पे केरला में मछुआरे बहुत मिलते हैं. ओके, तो आई रिमेम्बर सीइंग फ्यू फिशरमैन जब हम कभी बीच में जाते हैं. आई रिमेम्बर गोइंग टू अ रिजॉर्ट इन वर्कला, ढेर सारे मछुआरे. You know, when they are not fishing, they are doing what? You are called to be the fishers of men, right? So when these fishers are not fishing, they are mending their nets, cleaning their nets. If you are the fishers of men, you are at home, you are stuck. What are you doing? Are we mending our nets? Are we sharpening our axe? आपने सुना ही होगा. Anyway, मैं बोलते ही रहूँगा, by the way. So I'll come to the point which I have prepared for you. If you have the Bible with you right now, I want to tell you that government, you know, schools mein syllabus badalte rehte hain, upgrade karte hain, modify karte hain, NCERT, CBSE wagera wagera jo bhi affiliations hain. But there is this thing called the Holy Bible. 2000 saal ke upar ho gaya, abhi bhi waisa hi hai, utna hi powerful hai. It is the same yesterday, today and forever. Amen. If you believe it, shout an amen. Type an amen. Say hallelujah if you believe this. भले ही बहुत सारे versions होंगे, that's okay. But essence वही है. Praise the Lord. Essence वही है. So I want you to turn with me to Psalm chapter 1. Most of you might have by-hearted this psalm, and I will try to quickly share some very important points with you, and I'm sure those who are listening to me, it's going to help you, it's going to bless you. If you believe it, if you receive it, it's going to be a blessing for you. You might know a lot of things, maybe ye shayad suna hua hoga already, aapko bahut kuch pata hoga. It's okay, ask the Lord to fill you with a fresh anointing, with fresh learning. Okay, Psalm chapter 1, let's read it together. 1, 2, 3, I hope you're there. Let's read it. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. Before we move on to the next verse, are you blessed? Do you believe you are blessed? If you believe, just type it. I am blessed. I am blessed and I am highly favored. Do it. I am telling you, there is power even when you confess that. There is power. You believe it, you receive it. Hallelujah. Next verse. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, but whatever he does shall prosper. It doesn't say 30% of what he does will prosper, 20%, 50%, 90%, nahin. Soap ke advertisement mein dekhte hain, 99.9% germs maarta hai. वो 1% कहाँ जाता है पता नहीं, बट बाइबल टेल्स यू व्हाटएवर ही डस शैल प्रॉस्पर दोज हु डिलाइट इन द लॉर्ड. नेक्स्ट वर्स, द अनगॉडली आर नॉट सो. आपने जो ऊपर पढ़ा ना, वो गॉडली लोगों के लिए, वो ब्लेसेड लोगों के लिए, जो आपने लिखा ना, आई एम ब्लेस्ड, यू रोट राइट, आई एम हाईली फेवर्ड, इट्स फॉर यू. द अनगॉडली आर नॉट सो, बट आर लाइक द चैफ व्हिच द विंड ड्राइव्स अवे. देयरफॉर द अनगॉडली शैल नॉट स्टैंड इन द जजमेंट, नॉर सिनर्स इन द कॉन्ग्रीगेशन ऑफ द राइटस. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. The way of the ungodly shall perish. If you notice in the Bible, there are three basic things that you just read. Walks not, stands not, sits not. Walks not, say that with me, walks not, stands not, sits not. All of us would do these three exercises in life. We will all walk, right? We will all stand, we would all sit down. And the Bible is figuratively, it's symbolically explaining three basic vital concepts of life. To walk means to progress towards something, to grow towards something, right? Or advance towards your destiny when you're walking towards something. To stand means to take a position, to take a decision. And to sit down means to take comfort, means to take rest. And the Bible is talking about the comforts that you take, the rest that you take, the decisions that you make, the positions that you take, and the growth, the advancement, the development that you have to be according to the Word of God. There are people in this world who are growing, who take decisions, but contrary to the Holy Bible. And being the child of God, God wants you to take decisions, grow, and all that, take rest in a biblical manner. You know, the word, the Bible tells us in Genesis, he said to Adam, go and cultivate the land. Yeah, this word cultivate comes from the root word culture. Okay, I mean, the culture is the word that comes from the root word cultivate the land. So we see a lot of culture in our society, in our region, in the country, in the whole world. Different cultures, you know, some people have bilin rasta kaat liya to bhaiya ashubh hone wala hai, all those beliefs and faith. But God wants you to take all the culture in the kingdom way. Okay, it's not a Madhya Pradesh culture, Bhopali culture, it's the Bible culture that God wants you to take. Okay, aapke workplace mein jab aap rehte hain, God wants you to stand for your faith. Mera work culture thoda aisa hai, mujhe aisa karna padta hai. नहीं, परमेश्वर नहीं चाहता. परमेश्वर चाहता है आपका कल्चर किंगडम कल्चर हो, जो आपके द्वारा रिफ्लेक्ट. हमने अभी गाया मेरी रोशनी चमके ना, जो भी हमने रोशनी के बारे में, तो ये कैसे चमकेगा जब आप जिएंगे, है ना. कई जगह ये कई लोगों को लगता है ना कि पुराने कल्चर में ऐसा था. नहीं भाई, उससे पहले बाइबल में था बहुत सारी चीजें जो बाइबल हमें सिखाती है. आई रिमेम्बर वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स, you know, there was a mushroom-like plant in his house, जैसे glass में पानी भर के जो ऐसे रखते हैं ना, so the quality of that plant was, I don't know what that is, it sucks water really quickly, okay? तो उसमें अगर आप पानी डालोगे तो you can see the पानी getting absorbed quickly, ठीक है? तो इस दोस्त का थोड़ा creative दिमाग क्या किया, पानी की जगह ink डाल दिया. वो जो Camlin का ink वगैरह था ना, हम लोग बचपन में Chinese pen, ink pen से लिखते थे. बड़ा क्रिएटिव बंदा था, तो पानी इंक डाला तो वी वुड बी एबल टू सी दैट, यू नो, इंक इज एब्जॉर्ब सो क्विकली. तो जो क्लियर मशरूम लाइक प्लांट जो था वो ब्लू हो गया. मेनी ऑफ अस गॉड प्लांटेड इज क्रिस्टल क्लियर, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द कल्चर्स, बिकॉज ऑफ सम रॉन्ग डिसीजंस, सम रॉन्ग हैबिट्स, समथिंग दैट इज नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू द वर्ल्ड, वी हैव बिकम ब्लू और रेड और व्हाटएवर. बट गॉड क्रिएटेड अस टू बी होली एंड प्योर. I'm reminding you, your takeaway, sits not, stands not, walks not, in every aspect. This is a huge sermon, by the way, bahut lamba hai. I'm trying to concise it so that it blesses you, or I hope that, you know, it will bless you. TV, newspaper, internet, hamari thinking badalti hai. Jo hum dekhte hai, what you feed your mind with is what you become. क्या बोलते हैं उसको, रॉन्ग कंपनी करप्ट्स गुड हैबिट, राइट. अनगॉडली कंपनी में अगर आप रहते हैं, इट विल करप्ट योर गुड हैबिट. सो इन्फ्लुएंस योरसेल्फ फर्स्ट, फिल योरसेल्फ विद दिस प्रेजेंस, एम्प्टी योरसेल्फ ऑफ योरसेल्फ फर्स्ट, सो दैट ही कैन फिल यू विद हिज प्रेजेंस. हालेलुया. Praise the Lord. So how can you progress? When we talk about, so I'm just going to touch these three things. Walks not, stands not, sits not. By the way, it's a beautiful progression, right? Walk, stand, and then sit down. Beautiful. God is really creative. David ne jo likha hai, bada mast likha hai. So I want you to turn with me to John chapter 16 verse 24. Okay. If it's okay if you are not able to take, you can listen to me. I'm telling you that. John 16 verse 24 says, until now you have asked nothing in my name. Ask and you will receive that your joy may be full. आपको मिला नहीं क्योंकि आपने मांगा नहीं. या अगर आपने मांगा है तो शायद अपने selfish desires. I don't know. Pray in the will of God. I want you to know that. We need to learn to ask Him. Holy Spirit's obedience, guidance. That just like the word tells. And in that, until now you have asked nothing in my name. And you will receive that your joy may be full. We need to learn to ask Him. And you know, this learning also reminds me of some unlearning. Listen to me really carefully. Unlearning something that God is reminding us for. We need to unlearn a lot of things that we have learned over time. हमारे परिवार के traditions के कारण या you know, Bible में बहुत सारी जगह लिखा हुआ है. Pharisees के बारे में. Those people gave more importance to the traditions than the word of God. So God is reminding you. Unlearn few things and learn from Him. Hallelujah. Your progress should be in relationship with God Almighty. I think it's time, so I will quickly wrap up. Thank you for your patience. I really appreciate those of you who are still here. Bless you, my dear brothers and sisters. Let's continue in presence, in His presence. If you have some progress, which is not the progress according to the Bible, you need to say no to that. In your claiming patterns, in your workplace, I don't know what all. If you are growing in some way, मैं उन बड़े लोगों का नाम नहीं लेना चाहता जो बहुत they are very huge in the industry, or they are growing. Maybe they don't even know God. You might be questioning why they are so blessed and I am not. I am a believer of God. I am born again, baptized, serving God, but yet God is not listening to my prayers. God is not hearing me. No, buddy, I want to tell you, God wants you to grow in the biblical manner, more than the worldly sense. It's time that we are hungry for the Spirit. For put your mind on the things above, not on things below. मैं ये वर्ड्स जो बोल रहा हूँ ना, इतने सारे बाइबल में लिखे हैं, तो आप चेक कर लीजिएगा, ठीक है? God is reminding us. सब कुछ इसमें दिया हुआ है हमारे लिए. Hallelujah. One of my friends, और चलो ठीक है, friends का तो छोड़ो. हमारी body में अगर मान लो कहीं कोई extra growth हो रहा है, so will you be very happy? अब biceps grow हो रहे हैं तो ठीक है, but जहाँ पे growth normal नहीं है, it's dangerous, right? We call it, maybe it's tumorous or it's cancerous, because we don't want that kind of growth. That seems to be growth, but that's not the real growth, because we don't want growth which is out of order. There's a thing in science called mitosis, okay, which means cells growing at a correct pace. Would you like your cells to you know, get multiplied out of order? Yes or no? You can respond to that. Would you like to do that? No. So in the Spirit, God wants you to grow in the biblical manner. Many progress looks good, but it brings death. It is cancerous. That's why God wants you to grow. Walk not in the path of the sinner. You've read it, no? So young people, I want to tell you, progress in the word of the Lord. Yes, I am telling you, progress in the word of the Lord, because it's His love letter. बहुत बड़ा love letter है. सब कुछ इसमें दिया हुआ है. Progress. Second thing, don't stand that favors sin. First thing we spoke about walking, now we are telling about don't stand that favors sin. I want you this moment right now to maybe close your eyes and think about that weakness which you are struggling with, that maybe addiction or whatever. I don't know, you know it. Whatever it is, think of that weakness. Yes, take a moment. And I want to tell you, take a stand to cut it off. Resist the devil and he shall flee from you. The Bible tells us very clearly. First, we have to resist the devil. Then only he can flee. ये कोई joke नहीं है. It's the truth. It happens. I've experienced it. We are tempted in different ways. But if it's your mobile network, if your data, if your friend circle, if it's your cable operator, television में जो भी, if there is something that is causing you to sin, I want you to take a stand. Cut it off. बहुत सारी स्टोरीज हैं मेरे मन में. मैं आपको पता है कि पुराने जमाने में जब वुल्फ हंटर्स होते थे वो कैसे वुल्फ को मारते थे? आई विल टेल यू क्विकली. स्पीयर जो होता है ना उसमें कुछ मास थोड़ा सा लगा के, ठंड स्नोई एरिया है उसमें खून वगैरह लगा के, दे वुड पुट इट इन द स्नो. ओके, और उस स्नो में क्या होता है, वो वुल्फ खुशबू सूंघ के या उसको पता पड़ जाता है कि यहाँ पे मांस है या खून है, तो इट स्टार्ट्स लीकिंग दैट. एक्चुअली स्पीयर के ऊपर जो लेयर है, इट डजंट नो इट्स स्पीयर. ठंड के टाइम पे आपकी जुबान बिल्कुल सुन्न होगी, लिक करता है, इवेंचुअली कट्स इट्स ओन टंग. और वो मजे ले रहा है, उसको प्लेजर मिल रहा है, क्योंकि वो खून उसी का ही, उसे पता नहीं पड़ रहा. इवेंचुअली सारा खून खत्म, वुल्फ डाइस, हंटर आता है, वुल्फ उठा के चले जाते हैं उनका जो भी काम. ओके, सो दैट इज वन थिंग, दैट द थिंग दैट गिव्स यू टेम्पररी प्लेजर, यू माइट फील इट, बट गॉड वॉन्ट्स यू टू कट इट ऑफ. ओके, कट इट ऑफ. हालेलुया, वी मस्ट टेक अ स्टैंड, अ डिसीजन. हालेलुया, टेक अ स्टैंड फॉर जीसस, टेक अ स्टैंड फॉर जीसस. रोमन्स चैप्टर 5 verse 2. Let's go to Romans chapter 5 verse 2, which says, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Stand in the grace. I want you to stand in the grace. Hallelujah. Third point, very quickly, learn to sit and rest in His promises. Learn to sit in His promises. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There was one of the articles, corporate level पे एक आर्टिकल था जो रिव्यू था, बताया गया था कि कंपनीज में 40% ऑफ द टाइम इज स्पेंट इन गॉसिपिंग, पॉलिटिकिंग, नो पुलिंग डाउन समबडी, क्रिटिकिंग, इन सब चीज़ों में जा रहा है टाइम. ठीक है, तो अगर 1,00,000 अगर वैल्यू है टाइम की, तो उसमें 40,000 तो आपके गॉसिप में जा रहे हैं. कॉर्पोरेट का आर्टिकल है, भी मैं नहीं बोल रहा हूँ. ठीक है, आई हैव टू फाइंड, आई विल शेयर दैट. सो बाकी शायद टैक्स में चले जाता है 30%. एनीवे, जोक्स अपार्ट, सो डोंट टेक कंफर्ट इन सच थिंग्स. इफ यू हैव टू टेक अ डिसीजन, डोंट टेक दैट कंफर्ट व्हेन यू आर सिटिंग, आपके बाजू वाले क्रिटिकिंग करें गॉस्पेल, फॉर गॉड. हम कमजोर हैं, कई बार हम सी गलतियां होती हैं, इट्स फाइन, रिपेंट, आस्क गॉड फॉर फॉरगिवनेस, आस्क गॉड फॉर विजडम. आप सबको बहुत सारी चीजें पता होंगी, बट आई वांट टू टेल यू, इंफॉर्मेशन एंड नॉलेज विल नॉट हेल्प. Applied knowledge, applied information will help you. It's the anointing that makes a difference. Okay, we have to practice. We need to cultivate. We need to exercise. Instead of just knowing, we have to exercise and practice. That is what will help you. Hallelujah. It will, you know, if you take comfort in those kind of decisions or in instances, it might destroy your value system. It might destroy your future. So don't become a mediocre. I'm about to finish it very soon, very quickly. Just a few more points. Matthew 11 verse 28. Matthew 11 verse 28. It talks about the rest. Come to me, all who are labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. This is what I was saying. Come to me. God is not requesting, maybe He's demanding, He's commanding. Because He will give you rest. So rest in His presence. Tune your mind. आपने देखा ना, गिटार का थोड़ा ट्यून गड़बड़ा गया था, क्योंकि जितनी बार बजाते हैं, उठाते हैं, वो ट्यून चला जाता है, बट इट्स ओके. हमारा जो ट्यूनिंग प्रभु के साथ है, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. रेडियो में जब हम फ्रीक्वेंसी सेट करते हैं ना, थोड़ा ऊपर नीचे हो गया तो डिस्टॉर्टेड वॉइस आती है, वी डोंट हियर द क्लियर वॉइस. गॉड वॉन्ट्स यू टू ट्यून योर माइंड सो दैट यू हियर फ्रॉम हिम क्लियरली, एंड ही स्पीक्स, माई शीप हियर माई वॉइस. आमेन. आई फील गॉड इज रियली डीलिंग विद समवन. प्रेज द लॉर्ड. Quickly, Psalm, वापस Psalm में जाते हैं. The verse 3 says, He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. If you do verse 1 and 2, God says, you shall be. Say that with me, you shall be. God is not saying you may be, or I will think about it. Let me see if I can do something. If you do the verse 1 and 2, which we read, blessed is the man who walks under the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in His law, He meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Not by the roadside, not by municipal corporation. Rivers of water, where your roots are really strong. Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You are planted. Say that with me. I am planted. Tell yourself, I am planted. The job you are doing right now, you are planted there for a reason. The church you are there, wherever you are right now, you are planted. Tell the Lord. Use me, Lord. Hallelujah. You are planted. There are a lot of verses. I don't want to take much time now, but honor your leadership. I want to give you some takeaways. Honor your leadership. God is talking about bearing fruits in order. Okay, God is talking about bearing fruits in order. You have to be fruitful. God didn't say you shall be like the tree, as I said, in the roadside and all, but by the living waters. Hallelujah. There are things you have to say no. Say no. हालेलुया वो जैसे प्लांट होता है ना जो सनलाइट में करेक्ट सनलाइट में रहता है उसको सही क्लोरोफिल मिलता है सही पानी मिलता है गॉड वांट्स यू टू बी दैट प्लांट बाय द रिवर्स ऑफ वाटर दैट यू मे ग्रो एंड मल्टीप्लाई सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग एंड आई रियली बिलीव दैट दिस वाज अ ब्लेसिंग एंड थैंक यू फॉर योर पेशेंस इतना वक्त हो जाएगा पता नहीं था बट मेरी आदत से हमेशा से आई एम सॉरी बट थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर पेशेंस आई बिलीव दैट इट वाज अ ब्लेसिंग एंड आई जस्ट वांट टू रीइटरेट स्टैंड नॉट वॉक नॉट Sit not, progress. Walk not, stand not, sit not. In all the areas of your life. When Moses saw God in the burning bush, he went to the burning bush and he heard this voice. Moses, chappal bahar rakhe ho, because the place where you're standing is a holy place. Chappal bahar. There is no unholiness, no gandagi in this place. Aapki kya chappal hai? Kya hai wo aapke jeevan mein jo aapko bahar rakhne ke liye permission hai? It is between you and the Lord. I want to remind you one more time. It's time that you take a decision. You take growth, you progress, and you take comfort in the Lord. Cut off the things that God wants you to cut off. May the Lord bless you. Thank you so much for listening. Khuda aapko bahut barkat de, and I'm so happy. Aur importance of vision ka main fir se dhanyawad dena chahta hu uski leadership ka. Main naam nahi le raha hu, but jitne bhi log iske piche kaam kar rahe hain aur aradhna mein para dedication and commitment. I thank all of them. I bless all of them from the top of their head down to the soles of their feet. Okay, sir ke baal se pehle pairon ke talwe tak main parmeshwar ki aashish uske lahu ka covering prarthna karta hu. Thank you so much. Khuda aap sabko bahut aashish de. It is really important that you have a vision. For without vision, people perish. God bless you. Thank you.